Welcome back, students, to one more session of personality development. In our last session, we have talked about the last part of Sigmund Freud psychoanalytic analysis, that is the defense mechanism used by persons so that they can avoid the pain, or the defense mechanism that ego uses so that it can balance id and super ego. So today we'll study one more theory of personality, which is proposed by the psychologist called as George Kelly, and this theory is called as personal construct theory. So we'll see what this theory is. Before that, we'll look into a biography or details of Mr. Kelly. He was born in 1905 in USA, and his early education was in his house, and he was tutored by his parents. Okay, early schooling was in the home itself. Then he finished his college degree with a degree in physics and mathematics. So you might be just amazing that a psychologist who has done a degree in physics and mathematics. That is interesting. Yes, it's really interesting, because physics, mathematics is a base, or science is a base for any other degree or study of education. Then he has done his MA program in education and got a degree in education in 1930. At that time, he also became a research scholar in Scotland in the University of Edinburgh. After that, he went to Iowa State University and finished his psychology degree. Then he joined Navy in World War II as a psychologist, and he made two observations that accept and usually improves way of viewing situations. Means whatever we accept in life, okay, say whatever we expect the situation, the way we take it, that will have an impact on our behavior. And there are different ways in viewing different situation. Okay, like for example, if you are looking at a glass which is half full of water, some may say that it is half filled. Other may who can say he's a positive way of thinker. Another person may say the glass is half empty. So this is the negative aspects of life. You can say a saddest person. Still more, one more person may say the glass is full. Now you might say I am crazy. I'm not crazy. Actually, it is full, because it is having half liquid and half gas. So that is how you have to look at things. So this example says that we can view different ways the same situation. Okay, same person can view the same situation differently based on his mood, based on the temperament and environment, or the same situation can be viewed differently by different people. Why? Because people are different. Basically, we are not clones, we are totally different from each other. Now to continue, then he became a professor in psychology and director of clinical psychology, and then he started his career as a psychologist. Okay, so he worked for 19 years in Ohio State and as a psychologist. Then he died in 1967 at the age of 62 years. Now, how did Kelly view human beings? The theory that he proposed, we call it as role construct theory. Okay, Kelly says that human beings can develop their own way of anticipating future events accurately, okay, based on their past experience, based on what they have heard from friends, family, what they have seen around on television or in and around, okay, by observation, by personal experience, we can develop our own way of predicting future things. So it is like making decisions and choosing alternative actions. So I will predict the different ways of doing a thing, and the best way which will suit me, my budget, my situation, I will choose that action. So as you go on performing and experiencing life, you unravel or you try to know many different wonders or many some ways of doing things or behaving things. This is devised by the role construct test that was called as REP test. So Kelly says that human beings are, you know, a kit of trial and error. We anticipate events based on what has happened with us, with others, by observation, by learning and so on, and then we make a list of different alternatives and like A, B, C, D. Then I will choose the best one which will suit me and my situation. So his theory is based on personal construct and constructive alternatives. Now, what is a personal construct? Our individual way of devising, seeing, explaining, giving meaning and predicting life events. So I give an example of water, right? So how I interpret that glass, how can I explain it? So how will I explain it? So whatever we behave, it is a reflection of what has happened to us or what we have seen us. So we have our own personal construct based on what we understand, what we see, what we can, how we can attach it to our personal lives. Then based on that, I will not stick to one output. I will give different alternatives. Then the best one, I will channelize it so that I can behave in an accurate manner. Okay. So this personal construct is based on three things. We call it as a CPC cycle. C stands for circumspection. P stands for preemption. And the final C is control. So circumspection means a possible interpretation that can be labeled with trial and error. So whenever something new happens, I try to analyze it. Then I will do some research about it or ask somebody. Okay, so I'm going to try some things and make a list of different trials. So the making the list of different trials is preemptive phase. So the number of constructs that seem especially relevant to the situation. Okay, for example, if you talk about the current scenario, we are working from home or you are studying from home rather working from home. So here also we can make a CPC cycle. So when this all began, we all had to know, how can we teach you at home. Okay, so the different options where we can take Zoom sessions, Google sessions, we can send videos, we can send study material, right? So I'm trying to do different, I'm going to circumspect means possible interpretation. Okay, this situation is there. How can I handle it? Has this done before? Okay, so I'm trying to give a trial and error method. I'm trying different things out. So I took one or two Zoom sessions. Okay. Then there were some network issues. So we thought something else. Then I thought, okay, like this, I'm trying to rule out some game plan for it. Then the preemptive phase means I'm giving a number of constructs that seem especially relevant to this situation. Okay, so this situation, some options here are the different ones that just now I told you. Then as we started the things, we try to change certain things. Okay, Zoom is having some technical issues, some network issues. You all have lesser data. So what happens? Because one by one, one after the other, many classes are there, so you have a limited data packet. So what we do, you just mute it or you keep the video off. Okay, so what will happen? I will not know whether you are listening. Even today, even now also, I don't know whether you are watching my videos or comment, because you don't comment anything, right? So slowly I have to think about something else to control this situation. Okay, I'm taking live situation. You people are not speaking. You are not making me seen, whether you are present there or you are just putting it on and grooming. We never know. Okay, so how to control the situation? That is the control phase. The choice is made based on what can be done best so that I can try to manage some flaws in the system. So this is called as CP cycle. I gave you a general example. When the same thing is done based on our behavior thinking, it becomes psychological CPC analysis. Okay, then the next part is Kelly's theory is based on 11 corollaries. Now, what is a corollary? I think you remember teaching, learning geometry. We have theorems and their corollaries. Means theorems or corollaries means some standard rules or some laws which we can use to do something. Okay, so these are standard rules which are applicable everywhere. That is a corollary. Okay, then first one is construction corollary. Okay, this is based on the principle that repeated events are similar. Okay, so same thing happens to you again and again. Okay, you take it very lightly. Something new you are scared of, right? So when all this corona issue started, everybody was so scared. Nobody was dropping out of home. They were so scared. And it was so... Now, nobody is giving a damn out of it, right? Nobody is caring about what is happening. Chalta hai, ho raha hai, right? It will happen. Yes, it is like one more. That is, I think most of us are speaking in that terms, right? It is not a big deal. So same things are repeated again and again. You can predict that situation. Something new, it is really difficult or dangerous to predict. But when the repeated events are happening, the same thing is repeating, you can do a research and predict something. So that is called as construction corollary. Okay, then second one, individual corollary. Individual means people perceive events in different ways. Like for example, I told you, okay, that example of that glass, okay. So one glass is there, half water, half empty, or some may say it is full. So one simple event can be seen by different ways by different people. So that is individual corollary. Then organization corollary. So we arrange our constructs in patterns according to our view of their similarities and dissimilarities. So events are repeating. Okay. So similar kind of events are having similar outputs. Different events are having different outputs. So we are categorizing. This event is similar, so I'm grouping it in one. This is somewhat different, I'm keeping it aside. So you are trying to organize. Yeah, acha hai, bura hai, yeah, difficult hai. Something like that. Okay, so that is called as organization corollary. Next, dichotomy. Dichotomy means something which is two end or bipolar or anything which is having two results only. Yes, no, good, bad, right, wrong. So we can, you can say bifurcate events, our behavior, based on whether it was good, bad, right, wrong, ethical, unethical. Okay, so my behavior is just as good or bad. I'm not saying medium, addi, la. It is clearly bipolar. Either yes, either no. So it is either this extreme or that extreme. Okay, then choice corollary. Okay, the person will choose from that good and bad. Okay, I have a dichotomy. Whenever I behave like this, people will be hurt, people will be happy. Now, it is my choice whether I want to make people happy or I want to make people hurt. It is my choice that I want to be happy or I want others to be happy. So, you are making a construct. Okay, Say, for example, okay, this class PDCS, I can make it boring by just go on telling about theories as it is without any example. Or I can make it interesting with interesting examples. Okay, so I can make a choice of what will I do. Whether I want to make it interesting or boring, whether I'm going to teach it for the heck's sake because it is to be taught, or so that it will be useful for us. So there is a choice to be made. And the next one is range. Range means the endless events which are happening. Okay, so one by one something is going on happening. So how conveniently can I anticipate these range of events? Okay, so one single rule which is applicable for a variety of situations, a variety of events. Okay, so what works there? So okay, you say there are different types of problems arising. What can be one rule I can handle all the situations? That is, I should be positive. I shouldn't take tension. Okay, with a smile, with confidence, I do everything, everything will be at ease. So one solution to a number of problems, that is called as a range corollary. Okay, so it's like a one trump card. I can use it anywhere. Like for an example, when you play cards, right? There is a card which is having joker. It goes along with any card. So range corollary is something like that. One trump card, which is okay with every situation, every problem. So that in real life is positivity and smile, something like that. Okay. Then experience corollary. So whatever we are seeing, whatever is happening, we try to connect it with our past. Okay. Isi situation mein last time maine kya kiya tha, right? So we are trying to connect the present with our past experience and see, okay, so everything was good, any mistake, okay, this mistake I have done, this time I will just change it, I will modify it. Okay, so continuously you are trying to look back and you are going to correct the current situation. I can't correct my past, but I can use my past to change the future or present situation based on my past experience. That is experience corollary. Next, modulation. So modulation means seeing my past, I am going to change my present. I'm not going to change fully, but I'm trying to make small changes, small modulations. Okay. Then fragmentation. Fragmentation means one event, you're breaking down into small subsystems or small events so that it is easy to solve the problem or easy to analyze that situation or that behavior. Okay, so if say for example, if I give you a very silly example, when you must have seen your younger brother, sister, or remember when you were young, okay, when you're not eating properly, okay, your plate is in your plate that there is some food left, then what your mom does, she makes small bits or small bits she keeps aside and she says, this is mom, this is grandma. So she's feeding you in small bits. So she's trying to fragment you, feeling that I'm going to eat so much, I can't eat it. So what she does, she's breaking it out into small bits, small spoons, okay? So that you feel it is like a cake, okay, itna sa hi hai, next itna sa hi hai. So you feel it very easy. So you're going to break down the situation or problem into small events so that I can analyze it and tackle it easily. Then last two, commonality and social corollary. The commonality means when two small fragments are similar, okay, you feel happy, okay, this is easy, I can do it. So you are trying to club it them. So you are successfully trying to employ some commonness and then derive an solution to that problem, or you are trying to analyze your behavior. So something is common between different sets, you're trying to analyze it and infer it so that it will be easy to handle the further part of the problem. Lastly, social corollary. we may think so many things are right, wrong, but many a times as human being is a social being, we try to mend ourselves so that we look good in the eyes of others, in the eyes of society. So we are, even though we are right, but just because others are not feeling comfortable, we are trying to modify our behavior. So we are making a pretend, we are putting a mask so that outsiders or society feels comfortable. So modifying our behavior, no doubt it is right for us, but it is not right for somebody else. So you want to live in a society, so you are modifying your personality or behavior or attitude. That is called as social parole. So in care, what Kerry says is, by observation, by our past experience, and using these 11 corollaries, we are trying to behave in a one particular manner based on the situation, based on our right and wrong, and based on the society. So this is all about George Kelly's personality theory. You have any doubts, please raise questions. And it will be very wonderful if you comment so that I understand that you have seen the videos. Okay, the comments will be considered as attendance. Okay, so that's all for today. And this is all about Kelly's theory. I hope you have understood it. So have a good day. Bye.